Okay. You can just close that and put it on the handle for now.
We'll be starting in just 5 minutes for those of you who are watching the show. We'll be starting in 5 minutes. Besides, I hope you know what I have to remember. Sit down and get more. Well, the head is over here shortly, he needs to give some brief presentation. He had to go to St. John's Hospital to do a mass. It's a situation where he's please ask him to keep helping out. So once the police help each other out, so he should be pretty short. Why don't we start with prayer? In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Most of the loving God, during this difficult time in our lives, during this time of anticipation, we live in your hope of goodness. Heavenly Father, fill us with peace, and through your grace, may we bring an end to this epidemic that has changed our lives in such significant ways. Heavenly Father, may our anxiety be eased, and may we soon know who our next president is going to be. We pray for peace throughout this process, and we pray that the Holy Spirit be able to guide those in political positions who will be making decisions for us. Let them be guided by the Spirit. Let them be kind. Let them do your will. We ask this in the most holy name of Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We're living in some very difficult times. Does everyone here speak English or ready to learn English as well? Those are very important. We're living in difficult times these days. Our lives have been changed forever. People have been saying, I can't wait for things to get back to normal. We don't know what normal is anymore. We have to walk around with face masks. We have to walk around with sanitizers. Many of us are afraid to go shopping, to go to school, to come to church. Many of us are afraid of people being right next to us. And it's a real fear. Almost 250,000 people have died from this COVID. It's not a joke. Yet there's some people who still think that it's not real. It's not bogus if you lost a friend. It's not bogus if you lost a mother or a father or a brother or a sister or an aunt or an uncle or a grandparent. It's not bogus if a family member or a loved one is in the hospital and you can't visit them. It's very real and it's impacted all of us in one way or another. Sessions where there are some kids that are working from home and there are some most important thing for us. But I'd like to know if I may, how you feel and how you're dealing with this virus. So if some of you want to just share this with me, I'd be happy to hear. Because whatever you're feeling, I'm sure we're all feeling. I share how I feel. My feeling is a lot of fear and a lot of cautiousness. I'd like to know how you're feeling in this virus. There is a sense of helplessness. You want to do something, but you don't know why. When you see your families in suffering, what can I do? And there's nothing you can do because you have to worry about the self-isolating and not getting it. If you're working in the health field, you're afraid of getting at work and bringing home to your mother, your father, your grandmother. Been in a bubble. I was so happy when church opened up. Because at least a new school, a is at least I'm able to come back and see people. I'm a people person. And you all know how much I love the kids. You have no idea how much I miss Saturday mornings walking around, meeting up on the boys, and getting my hugs. Because they don't know danger. Their new normal has been changed. These are kids who, you know, when school first opened up, especially the older middle school, they came to middle school for the first time. And I'm walking around, there were some kids that were running towards me, running towards me. I'm back in the way. And I did that for 2 reasons. Number one, I'm learning to have a It's also vision. Parents are saying, what is that crazy thing you're doing? We don't know what you're doing. I don't know what your kids are doing either. But then you get the other side where the kids are wrong and help them and say, no, you don't want to go around. Where they're back in the way as if they have a disease. Because their parents are telling them, don't touch, don't help, don't do this, don't do that. So our kids are all in a flux. Just know that we're in this together as one family. Our church is open to business. We actually come here today, and there should be more people here, but I recognize that it's something that's a good way to come out to be public, and that's okay. That's why we're waiting. So we Press follow and you will receive all the messages I sent to you in real time. Go back to the networks. So if you can't participate in person, participate remotely. We don't stop our faith formation. Our faith formation has to continue. All right? So if you got envelopes, again, as we say every year, whatever goes into the envelope, that should come from the church. Give them an allowance, you can make something. So if it's 1 cent, 5 cents, 10 cents, it's coming from them. So they can take responsibility for their church as well. So they can come in, they can put that in the basket. If they want to take a collection, they can put it in the envelopes. If they want to drive it off the right way sometime. It's not about the money, it's about teaching them responsibility for their church. When they come here, they want to see the church, they want to see the lights on.
I just want to have a thought for you. Until the church is unified in the Lord. And when the poor people got together to have a faith, we're not talking about access, we're talking about justice. The bishop supported them, and therefore he became the governor of the government. As did some of his friends, some of his best friends, was a priest named Father Rubio Gregory. Father Rubio Gregory was traveling in a car towards his home, his parish minister, a little city called Aguilares. And while he was there, Romero said, we have to do something. We're going to have a procession.
be one, or it can be two. It's one man and one female. You can't have two godfathers or two godfathers. It's one man and one female. I always tell parents, choose wisely, because that person is stuck with you forever. You cannot change your godparents in 5 years, in 10 years, in 20 years, because you're now angry with them. They're your mama, you're your wife forever. So choose wisely. They have to be practicing Catholics. And people often ask, what is a practicing Catholic? Practicing Catholic is someone that comes to church on a regular basis. A Catholic church, a mass. It has to be someone who has been baptized, has received First Communion, and has been confirmed. All three sacraments of initiation. This is canon law. This is not Deacon Bellow law. This is not the Divorce law. This is canon law for all Catholic churches throughout the world. Now, there's some places where it's different than it's supposed to. Yes. It's not supposed to be done. So we have all the Divorce Charter of Ladies the correct way. So please don't ask us to do something that's out of line. Don't ask us to lie. Right? It's not good. Right? Because you know, sometimes what we do is we find ourselves teaching our children how to lie by our actions when we don't even realize it. When we come back to life and ask, there will be some well-intentioned grandmothers who would want to give the mass prize to the designated person. But when we use the envelopes to drop it off, the kids didn't come to mass, but they wanted the kids to get credit for being at mass. You'd be surprised if you can see them over there. I've seen them there with that door open, kids running out of the car, the kids running in, handing off the envelope to somebody and going back out to the car so that they can say that they were at mass when they weren't at mass. What is that parent teaching that child? You're teaching that child how to lie. You're teaching that child how to sin. And when the child gets older, it's about all these crazy things. So I say this now, the baptism is not going to be until February. So you can start thinking about who the godparents of your children are going to be. The same thing holds true for confirmation, that's for another conversation. But whoever the godparents are going to be, they have to go to the Catholic Church where they attend and get a certificate of eligibility that shows that they're eligible to the godparents. And I got to tell you, if they can't get that certificate of eligibility, it's because they can't get their parents. It's as simple as that. It means that they don't want to church. The priest of the ticket doesn't know them, or they haven't started their open their sacraments. And that's not something that you can do for them overnight. You say, well, you know, when can I come in and do my first community confirmation? It doesn't work like that. You've got to go through classes. All right, so the baptism, for those who want to be baptized, will be in February. And for all of the families, we have counts of baptism certificates. For some of you, particularly in second grade, we have those as well. Second grade students will make it in First Communion, or other students will make it in First Communion. Their first impression of First Communion will be in March, praise God. And then the First Communion will be in May or June. We have it scheduled for June already. Because the day that I had scheduled for the First Communion, we now have a confirmation day, because that's the only day that the bishop is available. So I'm still juggling the calendar. Throughout the year, we have some enrichment sessions such as this, and as things start winding down, we'll be able to get more people allows to be socially distanced. We will not be gathering in the gym as we usually do. The kids will walk into the building, they'll get temperature checked, and they'll go right to the classroom, right to the seats, and very good sanitized. We're going to dismiss them in different groups. We're going to ask that parents please be on time to pick up your children. We don't want any children running around the building. In the past, we allowed parents to come in and sit on the bench or to sit in my office. We're not allowed to make no one other than the children. Lessons. I hope to see you around in the church and start classes. I hope to see you.
die, but that you open day. So we know who's opening it. We know who's receiving it. The man says, I didn't care. My sister said, yes, you did it on such and such a day. And you read it on such and such a day. Yeah, everybody is watching this technology. Okay? So please, open up your stuff. And we have no problem answering your questions if you have any more concerns or confusion. Especially with the program that is crazy. It's been taken out by teachers a while. We're working on it. We're doing the best we can for what we have. Would you please stand? In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. We pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Lord, be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Go in peace. We hope to see you soon. Come to church. And love you guys a whole lot.
Also, but if you didn't have your headphones on, you couldn't hardly hear it, or you still could hear it.
It's not a muffle.
Thank you. Now we're testing the mic to see if it works. We're trying to get our best sound. Testing the mic. There it is. Now you can hear. Let's see. I think it's going to be good. So now we're just testing the sound to see. I think the weak link is what you did here, Cynthia, that this part, some part was not connected right. Yeah. We do our best.